second year 2-1, they kept the subject as Mathematical Foundations of Computer Science. The name itself, you come to know what kind of subject it is. It is a foundation for a computer science student mathematically. If you want to learn this, what we have to develop? You should develop your thinking capability. You have to develop, because you are all computer science students, must have the knowledge to create your own program. So that kind of creative knowledge you should have. With this, we can easily learn this Mathematical Foundations of Computer Science. The first unit is Mathematical Logic. First, we are going to see about what is mean by mathematical logic. So logic means is a study. It deals with various kinds of reasoning based upon a set of rules. What is mean by mathematical logic? In that logic, if you are putting some symbols, that is called mathematical logic. So the study of logic through the use of some symbols is also called mathematical or symbolic logic. Statement. What is meant by statement? Statement means it is a sentence. The sentence can be defined true or false, but not both at a time. You may say either it is true or it is false. For example, India is our country. I can say India is our country. So we can easily say whether it is true or false. Whether it is true or false, it is true. When I say India is a country, it is a sentence, but immediately I can say the value is true. India is our country is a statement. Statement means it's a sentence. If I say the sentence, immediately you can define whether the value of the sentence is true or false, but not both at a time. Okay. If I ask, what is your name? Can you define true or false for that? It is not possible. Okay. So what is your name is a what? Questionary. It is not a what statement. We cannot able to say true or false for that. The two possible values, either true or false, are called truth values. And these values are denoted by capital T or F. Sometimes it is also denoted by 1 or 0. Examples, India is a country. Yes, it is a country only. So therefore, the value of this is true. Hyderabad is the capital of Karnataka. It is wrong. And 41 is a prime number. What does mean by prime number? Prime number means the number divisible by 1 and itself is called prime number. Okay. So therefore, 41 is not divisible by any number like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. Only divisible by 1 and itself 41. So therefore, 41 is a prime number only. Therefore, the third example, 41 is a prime number, is a statement, and its truth value is T. And then the fourth example, 1 plus 5 equal to 8. It is not true, but it is a statement. We are getting the value. Easily we can say it is a false sentence. So therefore, it is also a statement. So here 1 and 3 have the truth value T, and the truth value of 2 and 4 is false. The next thing is special case. Special case means it is also a statement, but the truth value depends on the situation. Here I have taken 101 plus 1 equal to 110. If you see that statement as it is false only, because when you are doing the addition, 101 plus 1 is 102. But if you take the same what statement in the binary system, if you take in the binary system, it is 110. 1 plus 1 if you add, it is 2. So 2 means we have to put 0, carry 1. And here you can write 1 and another 1. So it is what? 110 in the binary system. So therefore, the statement 101 plus 1 equal to 110 is a statement, but the truth values depends on where we are defining the statement, either decimal system or binary system. If you define this in decimal system, it is false, because 102 is the answer. We have seen what is mean by statement, and I have given examples and all. So examples for not a statement. Now see that first one, may God bless you. So may God bless you means we can say it is a wish. We can say it is a wish only, but we cannot able to define either that may God bless you is true, or may God bless you is false, or we cannot able to say. So therefore, it is not a statement, just it is a wish. Please wait. So that is a request. It is not a statement. Please wait means we cannot able to say true or false. So therefore, please wait is a request. It is not a statement. The third one, close the door. Close the door means you are giving command to some person. What are you doing? So it is an inquiry. Okay. So what are you doing? The above are not a statements, because we cannot able to define a definite truth value for it. Move on to the next one. So another special case, this statement is false. So how can you define the what truth value for it? This statement is false. We cannot able to assign any truth value for this, because this statement is false. The statement is false means the truth value depends on this statement what we are taken for the discussion. That is the conclusion. Okay, so based on this only we can able to say whether it is true or it takes the value false. Without knowing the statement, we cannot able to say it is true or false. This example is called as semantic paradox. So notations for the statements, we will use only the capital letters to denote the statements, atomic or primary or primitive statements. The next definition, the statement which not contain any connective like, or, and, if, then, if and only if, like that, then it is called atomic statement or primary statement or primitive statement. For example, Ramu is a boy, Sachin is a cricketer. These are all not contain any connective. These are all simple statement. So therefore, it is called primitive, atomic or primary statements. So now we are going to introduce connectives in our statement. What is mean by connective? So connective means two simple statements are joined by a word. Word is called connective. So we are joining two statements with some word. The word is called connective. Here the words and phrases or symbols used to form a compound statements. The word or phrase or symbol is called connective. The main five connectives are, the first one is negation. The first one is negation. Second one is disjunction. And the third one is conjunction. Third one is conjunction. And then the fourth one is conditional or in simplification, we can say conditional, and the fifth one is biconditional. These are all the five main connectives for us. I'm going to explain first what is meant by negation. Negation. Suppose if you are taking P is a statement, because already we have discussed the statements are defined in a capital letter. So P is a statement we are considering. For that, the negation of the statement is defined as not P. Like 7, we have to write not P, or sometimes we may write like this also. These are all the notation for negation P. For example, I will take Dhoni as a good captain. This is a negation of the statement. Not P is, Dhoni is not a good captain. This is the example for negation. Suppose if you are taking P, 2 is an even number. So what is negation of the statement? 2 is not an even number. That is the example of your negation of the statement.